Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about projections. Suppose V is an inner product space. And W is a non-zero vector in V. If V is any vector in V, then projection of V on W is projection of VW. Now this will be some scalar multiple of W. Suppose we have a vector W and this is vector V. We are interested in the vector from, so this would be CW. The entire vector is W. Now this CW, so this will also be CW. So this will be V minus CW. And from the diagram, it is obvious that V minus CW is orthogonal to W. That is, inner product of V minus CW with W is equal to 0. That is, inner product of VW minus C times inner product of W with W equal to 0. So rearranging this, we get C to be inner product of VW over inner product of W with W. Therefore, projection of V over W is inner product of V with W over inner product of W with W into W. If W equal to span of U1, U2, U3, UN, then V belongs to V then projection of V over W is C1 U1 plus C2 U2 and so on up to CN UN. Now CI is inner product of V with UI over inner product of UI with itself. Now if we consider an example, say we have V equal to 1, minus 2, 3, minus 4, W equal to 1, 2, 1, 2. In R4, find projection of V on W. Now projection of V on W, this is inner product of VW over WW into W. So inner product of V on W will be, because we have R4, it will be the usual inner product, that is your dot product. So we have 1 into 1 plus minus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 1 plus minus 4 into 2. And this simplifies to 8. Inner product of W with over W, this will be 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 1 squared plus 2 squared, which is 10. Therefore, projection of V on W will be minus 8 by 10 into W, which is 4 by 5 into 1, 2, 1, 2, which is minus 4 by 5, minus 8 by 5, minus 4 by 5, minus 8 by 5. So this would be the projection of V on W. Now similarly, if we want to find projection of W on V, this will be W inner product of W on V over inner product of V with V into V. Now note that projection is not symmetric. Let us consider this example. We have a W, which is the subspace in R5 spanned by these two vectors, and V is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. The question is to find the projection of V on W. In the previous example, we had to find the projection of V on a single vector. Now in this case, we are finding projection of V on a subspace spanned by the two vectors. Now projection of V on W in this case will be C1 U1 plus C2 U2, where U1 is 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and U2 is 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 1. Now C1 is inner product of V with U1 over U1 U1, and C2 is inner product of V with U2 over inner product of U2 with U2. The inner product of V with U1 will be 1 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 1 plus 4 into 2 plus 6 into 1, and this will be 22. Inner product of U1 with U1 will be 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 1 squared, which is 11. Now this implies C1 is 22 by 11. Similarly, inner product of V with U2 will be 1 into 1 plus 2 into minus 1 plus 3 into 2 plus 4 into minus 1 plus 6 into 1, which is 7. Inner product of u2 with u2 will be 1 squared plus minus 1 squared plus 2 squared plus minus 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is 8. So this implies c2 is 7 by 8. So projection of V on W will be, now C1 is 22 by 11, which is 2 times 1, 2, 1, 2, 1 plus 7 by 8 times 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1. You can simplify this. This simplifies to 23 by 8. Thirty by 8, 25 by 8, 23 by 8. So when we have the span of vectors, the projection is a linear combination of the spanning set, and the scalars for the linear combination is given by these two. So in general, Ci is inner product of V with Ui over inner product of Ui with Ui. Let us consider an example with polynomials. Now we require projection of V on W, which is inner product of V with W over inner product of W with W into W. Now inner product of V with W is integral 0 to 1 t squared into t plus 3 dt, that is integral 0 to 1 t cube plus 3 t square dt, that is t power 4 by 4 plus t cube from 0 to 1. So inner product of V over W will be 1 by 4 plus 1, that is 5 by 4. Now inner product of W with W will be integral 0 to 1 t plus 3 squared dt. So this will be t plus 3 whole cube by 3 from 0 to 1. So when t equal to 1, we have 4 cube. When t equal to 0, we get 3 cube, that is 64 minus 9 . So projection of V over W will be 5 by 4 divided by 55 by 3 into t plus 3, that will be 3 divided by 44 into t plus 3. Let us consider the example of two matrices. We need the projection of A along B. So projection of A along B will be inner product of AB over inner product of BB into B. Now inner product of AB is trace of B transpose A. So if we recollect the inner product of matrices, this is sum of product of corresponding elements. So that will be 1 into 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 5 plus 4 into 5. So this will be 38. Now projection inner product of B on B will be one squared plus one squared plus five squared plus five squared, that is 52. So projection of A along B will be 38 over 52 into 1155. That will be